February 6th, 2016, for History in the Making, right here at Oak Forest High School. In a few minutes, our new state champions, Oak Forest High School's varsity cheer team from the medium division, will be arriving, and AC Variety is first on the scene. Stay tuned. You can find this exclusively on the ACV Television Network.com.
I don't watch TV, but when I do, I watch AC Variety.
I see that those side of the gears are turning, turning. What we said that you knew better, that you wouldn't bother if my talk is cheap and that got worthless. Here we go again, again.
Family is lining up as well as some friends. We found an alumni. Could you reintroduce yourself to your fans and tell us your feelings today to see the cheerleaders win state?
I'm Kayla. I cheered for Oak Forest. I'm varsity for 4 years at Oak Forest. I'm going to cry.
No, that's okay. Go for it.
I don't know. Just sorry. It feels really good to see them finally get what they deserve. And I don't know, I'm just really happy for them.
I believe you have a sister on the team as well, right?
Yeah, she's a freshman this year, so
wow.
It makes it even more enjoyable to see her live through what we couldn't do, so.
It's very exciting to see the family continue through that path. Is there any advice for people that may want to get involved in the future?
Oh, I think it's definitely something, if you're looking into it, to definitely get into. If it wasn't for cheerleading, like, I wouldn't have been involved in anything in school, and it kept me really involved in, like, I don't know, just it's a really good program. Coach D, Haley, Coach Kate, they really know what they're doing. So if you're thinking about it, even if you make a JV team, like the JV level's awesome. I advise you to try it.
And there's a lot of competitions that go on throughout the year too, as well as the Bengal Invitational. Do you get involved with that still?
Yeah, I work it every year for Coach D. I graduated in 2014. I worked it last year and this year, and we also host conference here, and I've worked that too. So yeah, I still work it. My mom still works it because my sisters.
That's what we love. When I get to go to these competitions, you see the alumni come back to help out as well as the parents because they love it. Thank you very much. We'll let you get in line, and let's see what else is going on as the Bengals arrive. State champs.
At home.
You
hit.
We're all ready for the girls to come, the coaches, yay, first place.
Thank you.
Bring it, buddy.
Yeah, that's what I have. Yeah,
takes care of her.
Oh my god.
That's what I got.
hashtag winners we are.
We will be the winners we are.
So we're here for the most important interview of the year thus far. We have the state champions, Oak Forest Spangles, over here. Can we introduce ourselves and tell us our feelings to achieve a goal that has not been achieved for such a long time?
Hi, I'm Nicole Neri, and it feels so good. After 2 years of getting 11th place, it feels so good to get on top.
Oh, I'm Rebecca, and it feels like a dream. It's unreal.
I'm Irina. I don't really have anything to say, but, you know, I'm happy, so
I'm going to the next person.
I'm Sandy, and I feel like I'm still sleeping at the hotel, and we haven't competed yet.
I'm Maddie, and I don't know.
I'm Nicole, and I'm really tired now.
I'm Emily, and I'm just happy to help make them accomplish their goal that they've been wanting for a while.
Before I continue, I'm sorry, I got to bring this up. I saw through the Twitter grapevine that someone had a birthday this weekend. I believe that's you. So since you weren't up here, I think we should all join in singing happy birthday on the count of three. One, two, three.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Emily. Happy birthday to you.
I have to say, was that the greatest birthday gift to Wynn State?
Yeah, definitely.
And you have three more years to do that, I believe.
Yeah.
It's been nice seeing you come up through the rankings over there and continuing on.
I'm Zoe, and it feels great to be a champion.
I'm Taylor, and it feels really good to be a state champion.
I'm Melissa, and it feels like no other feeling.
I'm Kylie, and it feels great to be a champion.
I'm Claire, and I'm just really happy.
You're a senior, too, so this is a great way to end the year, is it not?
Yeah, it is.
Take the rest of the school year off?
What?
You gonna take the rest of the school year off?
I wish.
Yeah, right?
I'm Erin, and this feels, like, unreal. It doesn't even feel like we just won. I don't know, it's awesome. Like, I can't believe it.
I'm Jessica, and I feel so happy, and, like, it's hard to explain, like, what you're feeling when you, like, would win such something big like that.
I'm Madison, and it feels amazing to win.
I'm Charlotte, and I'm so happy to be here! Woo!
Now I have to ask, I was reading the results online and everything. I saw we came in right behind Lamont by less than a point, and then you come today and you win by over 2 points. Is that a huge achievement, 2 points?
Boy, that is like kicking booty right in the face!
Now, there's a lot of people out there that don't know about the scoring system. Is there anyone that could talk about how scoring works here?
Charlotte. There's 10 different rubrics, and you get scored based on 1 to 10, and it's an average of all the different judges' scores, and the better you get, the higher you place, and there's deductions, which would be like 0.5, 1, or there's legality, so you really have to bring your A game to really do your great routine.
What are some of the specific things you get judged on?
Difficulty, voices, stunting, tumbling, synchronization, overall effect, most things like that. So
there's definitely a lot of work that goes into it, and you always hear that great music. Who comes up with the music choices for this?
Coach Caitlin and
the Defenties.
We'll have to talk to the coaches in a little bit over there. What's been some of the favorite songs you got to hear throughout this year? Do they usually just choose pop stuff? Can you do a little demo for us? Because I don't know.
Oh, we can sing our whole music.
Yes, please sing.
We're the Aqua Bangles. So. Maddie can take it.
She's a singer here. Sings the national anthem.
Yeah. We saw that at the Bengal Invitational.
Sing what?
Let's all sing it.
We're all singing.
We're singing.
Our music.
All right,
we're starting.
How does it start?
Oh, my Forest Bengals. You can't forget about me. While you were looking, I was getting even higher.
Hey.
Say what you want about me. You were the gasoline on my fire. Hey, we repping OIK. No matter what you say, Bengals want it all day. And it's all right, and it's coming home. We gotta get right back to where we started from. Love is good, love can be strong. We gotta get right back to where we
is definitely like you're all state champions up here. Now we have to ask the seniors, is there any parting words you want to give to the people in the future? Any parting words you like to give to the people in the future?
Get some rest next year's class.
He just put me in the seat.
You're used to that.
Do your best.
You're very professional.
Thanks. I would say I love this program and I love this team so much. And I will always remember this day and all my 4 years with them, and I will miss them very much.
And something just popped in my head. I was thinking, as you go from one day into the other, from Friday to Saturday, is there any head games going into there? You gotta be like nervous, thinking like the next day and everything.
No, you just gotta be chill. Just be chill.
Our team was really prepared, so we like didn't have any nerves or anything. We knew how to do every single thing, and it wasn't any different than any other competition day in practice.
It's really about us, so that's how we roll. Just think about us.
Live in the moment.
Live in the moment.
Motivational as always. Any final words from anyone else?
Live in the moment.
Yeah, live in the moment and love the moment.
Go Bengals!
Go Bengals! Yeah, baby! Yo, we state champs out here.
I'm literally a state champion.
I'm a state champ, and I'm a freshman, so that's pretty cool.
I'm just really happy right now.
I can't really keep my eyes open, but I'm happy to be a state champion.
I love my team. That's it.
State champion.
I love this program.
State champs!
Well, on behalf of AC Wright and Oak Forest, congratulations, ladies. You all deserved it, and we'll be seeing you in the future, I'm sure. Stay tuned. Let's see what else is going on here for the Bengal state champs.
Charlotte.
Zoe.
Michaela.
Angelina.
Abby.
Nicole.
Denise.
Morgan.
Elizabeth.
Mary.
Kayla.
Claire.
Megan.
Rachel.
Taylor.
And Cassie.
We love AC Variety! Woo!
Obviously, if you've been watching AC Variety for a while, you've seen these lovely cheerleaders rise from Oak Fest performances all the way to state now. It's always a great time. But behind them is the coaches, and we don't usually get to talk to them. Could you introduce yourself?
My name is Christine DeVenti.
I'm Caitlin DeVenti.
And I'm Haley.
DeVenti.
Family affair over here. How does it feel to win the state championship? I'd be about speechless too.
It doesn't feel real. Like when it happened, I was like, I can't explain it yet.
Yeah.
I
believe it. They worked very, very hard though, and we've said it from the beginning, they're a super special group of girls, and we are blessed to be able to get to spend so much time with them and learn from them and grow with them. And this is a result of a lot of people that have worked with us, believed in us, and helped us along the way, and a lot of faith and trust in one another. So,
how much work goes into it? How many times a week do they have to practice, and how long?
Like every day.
Really?
Yeah, really.
Seriously. Now, as we go from sectionals to state and all that, does it like kick up even more? Is it the same amount?
It's the same amount. The difference is that during our competitive season, we also cheer for all basketball games. So we typically have two games a week. So we cheer at all home and away basketball games, as well as prepare for the state competition.
Wow. I didn't realize how much. What's been the most difficult part about coaching?
Don't ask me that. I don't know. How many days have you spent with 18, 15 to 17-year-old girls?
It wasn't difficult with them.
It wasn't, though. They really do make us want to come to practice every day. We've enjoyed even the difficult days make the great days that much better. So they've made it so easy this year. And like I said, we're not ready to say goodbye to some of them. And
But we're so thankful that we've had those three seniors this year, and they've been tremendous leaders for the team. So they made it easy. They are the reason we coach.
After coaching a state championship team, I'm sure there's going to be a lot of people interested in joining cheerleading. Is there any advice for those younger people out there?
Don't be afraid of it. Don't be afraid of it. Most of these girls came in and they're doing things. They're doing things they didn't even know the names of. And they've worked hard and they worked together and they learned and grew their skills to the level that they're at.
I'm glad you mentioned some of the terms. Could you tell us some of the different things that they learn? I know I heard flyer before, stuff like that.
This year, low to highs, inversions.
What's that?
You flip upside down in a pyramid. I'll show
you, if you want. You could show us? Is that safe for them to show?
No, I can't.
There's a lot of safety concerns.
They did one of the things that separated them from the crowd this year was their stunt sequence, which was a low to high, but it was from a stretch to an arabesque. So those
at
are two words you haven't heard.
Routine.
At the end of the routine. And they did it with great skill.
That's true. And as you're talking about that, I'm thinking back to all the competitions. How many competitions do they have to do per year?
Well, we can compete up to 6 times exclusive of the state series. And we do compete at 6 events throughout the year, one being the conference championship here at Oak Forest that we have hosted 3 years in a row. But hopefully somebody else is going to take it next year because we're going to work hard. We do go to all 6.
Cool. Any concluding statements here today?
She hugged me and held my hand today. That's enough.
I cried. That's enough for all of you.
No.
We do love them. We are proud of them, and we appreciate all of their hard work.
I'll just say it's definitely a fun atmosphere over here. Congratulations on the hard work. Congrats. Congrats. And let's see what else is going on here for the Bengals state champs 2016.
Oh, yeah, they still got
a touchdown. I thought
2016.
No!
Tell me about this whip.
Well, I'm like the best dancer on this team. Like, I can dance really good. And, like, they just want me to.
You're going to have to show us to prove it.
Well, only Nicole's the second best. Yeah. All right, only if Nicole dances.
Okay, you're going to go for it.
Cue the music. Wait, what's it called? Now watch me. No,
we're out there. Wait, we got to cue some music here, right?
Some rules.
Give
us some room. Let's go.
Oh, no.
How does this feel to have the whole world be watching this just about?
Let's get ready to make the music.
Put it right on my phone. This is so embarrassing. Don't need to lie. Now watch me, nay.
Great job there. Where did you learn those moves?
I'm just natural. It comes naturally.
It's a natural thing. You're born with it or you're not.
Yeah, since you two like to dance, what possessed you to join cheerleading instead of proms?
Because I can't like jump, like leaps and all that crazy turn stuff. I can't do that.
I enjoy cheerleading a lot more.
Yeah. Did you both cheerlead in Hilly Middle School?
Yeah.
What's been some of your favorite memories from this first year?
Winning state.
Yeah, that's true. I guess I should.
Just knowing that all of our hard work paid off from the past 9 months. So
especially conditioning. Oh, so happy that paid off.
How does it feel to be varsity on your freshman year?
Really cool. It's awesome. It's fun.
You completed what many people that go here never have the opportunity to do. So my hat's off to both of you. We'll see you later this summer.
Thank you.
As things are winding down here at Oak Forest High School, we caught up with one of the alum. Could you reintroduce yourself to your fans and tell us your role with the team?
My name is Amanda Rizzuti. I'm an alum from the Oak Forest Varsity Cheerleading Class of 2011, and I also coach the JV cheer team here at Oak Forest.
What did it feel like to be there witnessing the state championship?
It was unreal. I've been there times before, but it was nothing like crossing the podium, being called as a state champion. It was an unbelievable moment for the girls because they worked so hard and they put their soul into the season and into the routine, and it was just nice to see it all pay off. And I know it's a day that, like, our family at Oak Forest as a whole on the cheerleading team, they're never going to forget that. So.
What were some of the most stressful parts of these past 2 days?
I think we all believed in each other and knew that the girls were going to go out there and do what they needed to do, but just it being a waiting game and not knowing, because you can only control what you do, so we were only really worried about ourselves, but the waiting game and not knowing the outcome was probably the hardest part for us because we were so anxious.
I was talking to some of the parents, and they said that they're just as stressed as the girls are.
Yeah.
Was it like the longest moment ever when they announced that Lamont is number two?
Not necessarily the longest moment ever, but... like I said, the build-up and the waiting game, because then you start thinking, did we do something wrong? Like, you don't know who's going to be called as number one. So the build-up, like you said, it definitely builds anxiety, but yeah.
Looking forward to next year?
Absolutely. I'll be here as long as Coach DeVenti's here. I'll never leave.
And how does it feel to be back on AC Variety? It's been years ago. You used to be involved with Relay for Life for your first interview, I believe.
It feels good. We love AC Variety, and we love having you guys support us the whole season.
Thank you. We'll see you at Oak Fest this year, and stay tuned as we wrap things up for the state champion Bengals.
Thank you.
Hope you enjoyed this special presentation welcoming home the 2016 state cheerleading champion Oak Forest Bengals right here at Oak Forest High School. Saw a lot of family, interviewed some of the alumni, talked to the cheerleaders, seniors, freshmen, sang happy birthday, talked to the coaches. It was a moment that I know I'll never forget and they'll never forget. I just like to say, we like to say at AC Variety, the big stations don't want to cover events like this. Well, I got something for you. This is what people want to see. Until next time, this is Clem, and for more information, go to acvtelevisionnetwork.com, and I'll see you on TV. I see that look, cause I think gears are turning, turning. You always said that you knew better, that you wouldn't bother if my talk is cheap, and that got worthless. Here we go again.